So, let us start our class and hopefully we will finish a few minutes early tonight. So if we go to our first year experience page and if we look at our schedule, that you see that according to our schedule, your one will be in your next lecture. Next lecture, we will have test one, and test one will be duration 50 minutes. Maybe 45 or 50 minutes. So it will start one time. If you are late, then I will not be able to give you extra time. If you miss your test one or do not appear for your test one, then your final exam will compensate. But if you enter into this room and see that test paper, you will be able to get that. Anyone, I passed a study guide on D2L through an announcement. Everybody got that? Anyone has any question about that? So for our test one, we will cover sorting. For instance, you will be given a data set, 6, 7, 8 data numbers in random order, and you will be asked steps, write out the steps every phase for a selection sort or a bubble sort. You have to write down the what will be the ending result after every phase, the cycle. You need to remember or write down the entire algorithm. Okay. And so you will be asked to write a class, develop a class. You need to remember that the previous class before the last class, I discussed how to develop a class, a dog class, how to create constructor, and how to generate or get getter and setters, and how to create object, how to use this object in order to call the getter method, setter method, and how to write a method to display the elements. And you are given either a two-dimensional, for instance, a two-dimensional array, you will be asked to find a number, for instance, sum of all numbers, or sum of even numbers, sum of all negative numbers, sum of all positive numbers, something like this. And as static member, static modifier in our last, there will be a question on that. Static modifier. This is static modifier we discussed. I can review quickly again about static tonight. And mainly tonight, we'll discuss inheritance. And if I have time, then we will discuss polymorphism. Otherwise, we will cover polymorphism in our. By the way, I need your opinion. Do you want me to discuss live program on computer or to use whiteboard and write down code? Whiteboard? My computer or this computer or your computer? Okay, so is there any issue on sound? My English is weird, right? American. So give attention. What I'm saying, I'm giving attention. The reason is that I want to restrict you not to open any device. It's not my personal interest. I will not gain a penny for that. Okay, let's see that you focus on this. It's really an important and top. We have to cover a lot of things. Okay, so let us see what we do. And I encourage everybody to use GitHub. A tool that all companies are using. All companies are using. So if you start using GitHub, for instance, right now, 2 or last 3 or 4 years, you will be an expert on using GitHub. One step ahead. Even if you start using GitHub in this semester, so you will be ahead of even some senior student or some graduate student. Computer is slow. Okay, so we were discussing static modifier. Static modifier is you. Static modifier is used as a member of whole, okay, as a representative of whole class, not only for a specific object. Okay. If I get my Eclipse open. If we want to keep track, how many objects we have created for a class, then it is we need to use a static variable in order to count the number of objects, and we can increase that static variable within the what is that called constructor. I want to discuss that program. Let me see. Okay, so static attribute in Java, we were discussing this. Slow. Time it opens, it starts up. Let me discuss. I will show you a live program with static again. Inheritance is one of the five properties of object oriented. First property of object oriented programming is class. We discussed that through we develop or we design a new class. Right? When you create a class, when you design a class, we create as many number of instances of that class, that object, as we need. And sometimes we'll have some defined classes that some people or other people will be developed, then we will be using that data type. The process inherit in our life. We inherit properties from our parents or grandparents, right? From our relatives. We inherit properties. Object-oriented programming, the concept of object-oriented programming is to develop programs that will be more. Yes. We will discuss inheritance today. But for instance, Finish our discussion about static modifier. For instance, we have a static modifier over here. So dog count, static integer dog count, initially we put 0. Okay. So actually we need initializing my computer is full. And you see that? Okay, so this is my class. Then what we need, for instance, that my dog count in